Today we're going to see how to get a unique tag ID when using the RC522 RFID module with Arduino. Here's a look at the module. I'm sure many of you have it, especially if you started out with the Arduino kit, if you purchased that online. This is the module we'll be using today, and we'll swipe the ID cards that come with it to get that unique tag. There are 8 pins on this module, and we'll be using all the pins except one in the middle, the IRQ pin. This is the wiring for the Arduino Mega. The SDA pin will be attached to 53, the SCK pin will be attached to 52, the MOSI pin attached to 51, the MISO pin attached to 50, the RST pin attached to pin 5, and then you got your ground and your VCC, which is 3.3 volt. If you're using Arduino Mega, it should look something like this. We're going to power it directly from the board at the 3.3 volt and ground pins. Now we're going to open up Arduino IDE and go to examples and go to our MFRC522 library, and we're going to click on one of the examples there that we can scan the tags in. Let's go down to dump info, click on that. If you're using a different Arduino board like an Uno or a Nano, it'll tell you within the code exactly where to make those pin attachments, and some of you may find this helpful as well. Since we're using the Mega board, we're going to go down here and make a few changes. We're going to put the RST pin on pin 5, and the SS pin will be pin 53. Next thing we're going to do is make sure that we have the right board selected and the right port. For me, it's Arduino Mega and COM5. And you can do a search for your Arduino board right up here in the search bar. Then we can click OK, go up here to the top, and then we upload this program to our Arduino. And now we open the serial monitor. You can't see it, but it's in the top right corner. I'm not sure what all the blocks are for, but make sure you have your baud speed set at 9600. And we'll go ahead and scan our first ID here. And you want to hold it in place until it's done scanning. And once it gets to the bottom, you can see that bottom row on the left here. These are the numbers that's your unique tag. Now all these numbers displayed on your screen here are from your ID card memory, and the memory is separated into blocks and sectors, and within those blocks at the bottom is your unique tag. And for our second card here, our unique tag is 3A8B951A, and that is what you need when you want to scan your tag to make something happen within your projects. Now here's another white card. I have multiple cards. I just want to show you that the ID number is going to be different than the first white card that I scanned, and we'll see it right here, totally different. So each card is indeed unique. And once you get that unique ID for your card, you're going to copy and paste that right into your code. This is an example of an RFID lock that I did previously. We're going to paste that ID right into the code here, and we're going to do the same thing for our first card. We're going to scan our first card, get that ID at the bottom, copy and paste it back into our code as an ID for card number 1. And if you're using something other than Arduino Mega, don't forget to change your SS pin and RST pin numbers up here at the top. If you're having a hard time getting this to work, you may want to check your wiring, make sure you got all the pins correct. If that doesn't work, you can hit the reset button on your Arduino board. If that doesn't work, maybe you can change the USB port that you're using on your computer, or you can reboot the whole thing. Arduino IDE, reboot your Arduino, and if all else fails, you can try another RFID module. Thank you very much for watching. I do appreciate it. I hope this was helpful to you. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. And I'll see you again very soon with another Arduino video.